Needle Park. This is Needle Park. And the reason why they call this place Needle Park is because there's needles everywhere. Everywhere. You gotta be careful where you walk, because you definitely don't want to step on a needle and have that injected in your body. And then now you become an addict. But so I'm here ministering to people, telling people about Jesus, offering people help. This is what I do. Hey, you know what? I spend so much time here in Philadelphia now that as I walk around, some people know me, some people remember me from walking through here before. It's to the point where it's like this place is like it's my neighborhood now. You know. They don't like when you film out here. They don't like when you do that. They don't like when you film them. I just got into not an argument, but a little young guy said he didn't want to be in the video. I told him, don't worry about it. I ain't gonna put you in the video. I was videotaping somebody else and he walked in and he got caught up in it. But you know, I'm gonna make sure I don't put him in there. He asked me not to put him in there. I'm gonna make sure I do that. So you will never see him. You will never see who he is. I told him about my website. I told him about my YouTube channel. So, you know, he could go on there. I told him you could go on there. You'll never see your face on there. I'll make sure I delete you out. Anyway, so he understood. We walked away in peace. That's what it's about. You know, I try to be peaceful. In the beginning, I'm not too good with somebody telling me I can't do this and they don't want me to do that. I'm not really not too good with that in the beginning. But once the Holy Ghost kick in, I'll be more understanding. I'll say, you know what, you're right. All right, I got you. And me and him, we talked about it and we worked this stuff out, gave each other a dap, and I walked off. You know, and that's how it is, right? When you're a Christian, you gotta keep it Christian wherever you go. You know, when I was in the hood, when I was growing up, when I was a gang member and we used to leave the hood, the homies used to tell us, because we got to get on a bus and we got to take this bus way across town to go to school. We're not in the hood anymore. So the same way that we wore our blue hats and had it cocked to the right, and we wore our 6-point star chains out, and we wore our blue rags in our right hand, in our right pocket, back pocket hanging down, the homies used to tell you, keep it G, keep it gangster today. That meant wherever you go, people should know that you are a GD. Well, that was back then. I'm no longer a GD no more. I am now a Christian. So I look at it the same way, that wherever I go, I keep it Christian. You know, I always keep it Christian wherever I go. You know, I let everybody know who I am. I'm Joe the Street Preacher. I'm a Christian. I'm a follower of Jesus Christ. No matter where I go, if I'm on a bus, if I'm on a plane, if I'm in a truck, if I'm in this city, am I in that city or that state, I'm going to keep it Christian. So, with that being said, the little altercation I had with the young fellow, it wasn't an altercation, we weren't in a fight or nothing, but he got kind of hostile a little bit, and I started off getting hostile. And then, you know, I had to catch myself and say, hold up, man, I got to keep it Christian. Because if I don't keep it Christian, then I'm going to go back to my old ways and keep it gangster. I don't want to keep it gangster. If you get in trouble, keep it gangster. I don't want to do that. I don't want to be in no trouble. I don't want to hurt nobody. I don't want to get hurt. I don't want to fight. I don't want to do nothing. I just want to be a Christian. So, that's why I say, man, y'all continue to pray for me, because sometimes out here I deal with people with all kind of different attitudes, you know. And I just try to walk worthy of the calling. But anyway, so that's basically that. Y'all keep Junior in prayer, and I'm going to find somebody else for the next upload. So y'all stay tuned.
No, I'm good. I'm good. Yeah. What is that? Cologne?
Like the sub.
Yeah, I'm good.
Brand new socks and toothpaste.
I'm good. Thanks.
Huh?
Yo, I'm looking for an iPhone 6, dog. I don't know what's up with y'all. Don't disrespect nobody. I ain't one of them, dog. Real shit. Y'all want to say, hey, get high, get high.
Sleep out here. Don't nod out here with your phone, man. They're gonna take it, man. They're gonna take it, man. Yeah, they're gonna take it, man. They don't care if you 6 feet. They don't care if you 250 pounds. You sleeping? They got that. They got that monkey on their shoulder. They gotta get it. Yeah, it's happened to a lot of people out of here, man. That's the story of a lot of people. Yeah. So yeah, you can't have that and nod off, man.
I have my personal.
All you doing, man?
You ready to go?
Yo, what's up, man? Don't do it. You know that stuff no good for you, right?
Oh, I know.
Huh?
I know.
Is that the fentanyl with the train?
Yeah.
Yeah, that is poisonous.
I'm out here now.
Yeah, it's poisonous. You know, that stuff right there is tearing up people's skin, their flesh, putting holes in their skin.
Well, I start methadone in 2 weeks.
Huh?
I start methadone in 2 weeks.
What, you going to a rehab?
No, I'm getting on the methadone clinic.
The methadone clinic? And that'll help get you off of this?
Yeah.
All right. All
Yeah, so that's the life down there in Needle Park, Kensington Avenue, and also Allegheny Avenue. People lose their phones, their purses, their watches, their shoes. When you go to sleep, which what he called nodding off, we call it going to sleep, because those drugs cause you to nod off. If you remember what he said when I asked him, how did he lose his phone? This is what he said.
How did they get your phone?
I nodded off.
You nodded off, yeah.
So nodding off, you're actually in a deep sleep. This is when the people come around and steal your bag. And people have bags, man. People come from out of town, come from different cities with backpacks. Inside that backpack, they have their wallet. Women have their purses. With their ID in there, with their social security card, with their birth certificates in there. And they lose all these things because when they wake up after nodding off, these things are gone. You know, and then they get depressed because now they don't have ID to be able to catch a bus to go back to the town that they came from, and they end up getting stuck down there. They end up getting depressed because they lost their ID. You know, a lot of them have money in there. You know, so you can't go down there around other drug addicts that don't have a way of making money to support their habit. And here you is with a nice pretty bag or a nice phone laid down beside you while you nod off. And you think that these temptations is not gonna cause them to go to that phone or that bag and take it and walk away. That's what they do down there. I can't even count how many times I have spoken to somebody. I always try to stay connected to the people down there in Kensington Avenue. by way of getting their phone number so I could continue to keep talking to them. But man, I'm telling you, everyone that I run into and I try to collect their phone number, they always tell me they don't have a phone. Their phone was stolen out here. Because if you nod off, because these drugs cause you to go into a deep sleep that people can actually go in your pockets and you don't even know it. That's how deep of a sleep you're in. So I know on the poster it made it seem like I got my phone taken, but I was just repeating, you know, what the man said. You know, the man said somebody stole my iPhone, you know, and it happened right there in Needle Park. It wasn't me, because I'm not going to nod off. I'm not going to go to sleep down there, you know. So anyway, so that's what happens down there. You know, that happens a lot. You know, I see people, it's countless times I have walked down there and I have seen women, you know, out like a light. And a big old pocketbook is standing right beside them. It's right beside them. They're not even holding on to it or anything. And that is so easy for somebody who's an addict to come by and just pick that whole bag up and walk away. It's so easy to do that. You know, and they go around the corner and they get your money. You know, and that's probably enough for them to get high for a week. Or they get your cell phone. Your cell phone might be worth $500, $600, $700. They'll sell it for $100. People will buy it right away. You know, and that $100 is $100 worth of high for them for the whole week. You know, that's all they look at it as. So, you know, people got, I try to tell people when I witness it to them, stop going to sleep and leaving your bags there. Stop putting all your money in your pocket. Stop nodding off. Stop doing drugs. Basically, that's basically what I've been telling them. But, you know, and you saw that lady. At the end of the video, you saw that lady that I walked up on, the little girl. She's getting ready to stick that needle in her arm. You know, you caught that on the video, but it's a lot of times while I'm walking through there, I see that, you know, and I always try to talk them into not doing it, but they always have an excuse. Oh yeah, this is gonna be the last one. You know, I got 2 more weeks before I start methadone. But see, the problem with that is, you don't know if that very same needle that you stick in your body is going to be the last one. You don't know if you're going to OD off of that. You know, and that's what I try to tell them. You know, you don't know. This might be the very last one. This one might cause you to go into a drug overdose and die. You know? So these things are dangerous. Like I said, I make these videos to raise awareness of what's going on. You know, I have a lot of things of why I do it. You know, I do it to try to raise awareness. Hopefully that you guys can see it. You might have a family member that's struggling with drugs. You know, this will cause you to show them the video and they can see people's arms and legs, you know, being eaten up by these drugs. And maybe that can scare them into saying, you know what, I'm out of here. I don't want no more of these drugs. You know, or maybe you might be thinking about taking drugs. You know, and this video could cause you to say, you know what, I'm not going to do it. So that's why I'm saying that I'm raising awareness. And also, you know, I in this video, I'm ministering to people because my purpose of being down there is to try to talk some sense into people. You know, try to get them something to think about. You know, it's hard, man, to try to get them to walk away from that life. It really is. They don't want to do that. They don't want to do that. You know, but you never know. You know, you just got to go out there and keep talking to them because you never know. You never know who's going to say, you know, I had a guy that said, man, I'm done. And I took him over to rehab. Who's to tell that the very next person I talk to might not say the same thing? You never know, you know. My thing is to just do it, you know, just talk to them. Give them something to think about. They might not change their mind right there, but the things that I've said might continue to just ring in their head for the next couple of days. And who knows? I won't know because I won't see him again. You know, and who knows that after a couple of days they say, you know what, that preacher was right, man. I'm about to go to the rehab. I'm tired of this. This person just died. I don't want that to be me. See, I don't get a chance to see afterwards what happened. All I do is just go forth and just tell them, you know, give them something to think about. So anyway, y'all just keep me in prayer. I want to thank each and every one of y'all too before I close this video. Y'all showed a lot of love to my daughter Faith when I posted that video of her birthday party. I felt like if I'm gonna have a birthday party, y'all always with me in Kensington Avenue, why not come with us to Chuck E. Cheese? And I posted that video and so many of you guys have posted happy birthday, Faith. We love you, Faith. God bless you, Faith. And all these things. And my daughter sat there and read it, and it really touched her to see the love that's coming to her from people in another country, in another state. All the people that don't even know her, just the love that you showed my daughter. Me and my wife, we really appreciate, you know, the things that you guys said, and the hearts that you put on there and everything. And trust me, my daughter's been reading all of it. And she's amazed. Every day she goes, she see more comments and more love, you know. So I really appreciate y'all, man. I really thank y'all for that. And I just ask that you continue to keep watching this channel and continue to keep me and the people in Kensington Avenue in prayer. Pray for me that I will be able to reach somebody and touch somebody and bring them to the rehab, and pray for them that they would just give up, you know, give up on doing these drugs and go get some help. That's the prayer that I want you guys to keep us in prayer. Anyway, thank you once again for all the new subscribers. I love each and every one of y'all. I love when y'all leave comments. I do try my best. Some of these comments, you got to remember, when I first started out, I only had about 5 or 6 comments, maybe 10, 15 comments. It was easy to answer everybody back. But now I look, sometimes I got 100, 200, 300, 400 comments. It's hard because I'm a very hardworking man. I'm a very busy man. It's kind of hard to answer everybody back. But I do try. And if I missed your comment, I'm sorry. You know, as long as it wasn't nothing negative, I'm sorry, you know, that I didn't answer back. But, you know, I really appreciate everything that y'all said and everything. I just appreciate the love. You know, I'm Joe the Street Preacher. Thank you for watching this channel. And God bless each and every one of y'all. Thank you.
I know that my Savior lives. And at the end, He will stand on this earth. My flesh may be destroyed, yet from this body, I will see God. Yes, I will see Him for myself, and I long for that moment. Grandma, I really miss you, and it ain't been the same. I drop a tear when I hear your name. Mariella Holloway, why you gotta be so far away? Used to say, don't worry, it's gonna be okay. But it ain't, it's like when you left, you took the Lord with you. Why couldn't I come when He came to get you? Damn, I really miss you. To say it again, I remember the time when I was like 10, crept up in the neighbor's yard, yeah, being hard-headed. You told me I would get it, you said it, and boy did I get it. But after you spanked me, you hugged me, kissed me on my forehead, told me that you loved me, and I saw that it hurt you more than it hurt me. I thought, how bad could this hurt be? I know now, that's why it's only done out of love. What I wouldn't give for one more hug from Grandma.
Baby, it's gonna